Hi everybody, today we're talking about row level security in Excel. Now, Excel doesn't really have great enterprise level security. We know it has some usernames and passwords and things like that, some sort of block cells, but doesn't really have enterprise level security. However, if you add a little Excel add-in, you can get row level security in Excel, and that brings massive benefits to you and your organization. So I'm going to show you a little demo of how you could implement that and how easy it is to manage. All right, so today we're going to be looking at collaboration in Excel with row level security or enterprise row level security. And I've got three different environments for you today, so we can just check out all the different options. So with our technology, you can introduce two types of security. One is your standard username password, and the second is your integrated Windows security. And I'm going to show you both. So let's just start with the username and password. So here I'm going to open up a Excel workbook that's got a link to a centralized database. And when I try to ask for some data, it's going to ask me for my username and password. So I've got a demo admin and a simple password. And it's logged me in, and now I'm able to access some data centrally with like a pivot table functionality. It's got, I can change my filters with this nice little wizard, but basically I'm getting some data from a central database. Now I'm going to go to a totally different environment. This is Azure Remote Desktop. I'm going to bring that up. And in this one, I'm logging in using my Windows username, and the software and my add-in PowerExcel is going to identify the fact that I'm logged in using Windows, and it's automatically going to authenticate me. So we're going to open up something that looks similar, and by design, I've changed the color schemes around a little bit so that it's obvious to identify. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tile these up for you so we can see both side by side. Put that one there, pick this one up here. And now you should be able to see that the numbers are the same, the color schemes are slightly different, and these are two different environments. This one's on my laptop, this one's in the cloud. But I can collaborate. So if I change a number here, and it updates on this side, and if I go over here and ask it to update on this side, I get the exact same numbers, the same calculations. So I'm able to collaborate really nicely globally. But what we want to do now is have a look at what I can do with security. So I'm going to bring up another environment. This is our centralized database and our graphic user interface. This is called Olation, and we're in Olation Studio. And here I'm going to look at the rules that I've got. So very simple, right-click, edit security. And you can see I've got two rules, one for my manual demo admin and one for my Windows login. So the first thing I'm going to show you is, if you look at them, you'll see that both of them have write permissions. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change one of them to read only. Very simple. I just click on the rule. I go right click. And it's asking me what type of permissions, and I can go straight away to read. Hit save. Now, if we have a look at that environment now, we've now turned one to read and one to write. So this one, I believe this one's the read only. If I try to change that, it's straight away giving me error. I can't make any changes. So if I come over, if I just ask for that data back again. Now if I come over to this one though, this one's got still got the write access. If I change that, calculate there and I calculate here, you'll see that my data remains the same. So I'm able to collaborate and I can turn on and off my write access. So that's really powerful. The second thing though is I want to talk about row level security. So I'm going to go back into the central database and I'm going to show you how we can limit what people can see. So if you have a look at the syntax here, it's really nice and simple and easy for us to use. We've got one cube, one database, and these are all the dimensions that we've seen. We've seen that we've got a product, we've got a region, and I'm going to show you the month dimension, which is the one that we all can see very obviously. And how do I change what this person can see? And I've got a really nice user interface. And this is the idea, is that this is everything they could see, and this is what I'm going to allow them to see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, okay, this person, all I'm going to do is drag from left to right. This person I'm going to show January, and this one, and I'm going to show Q1, And then for the other, for the Windows user, I'm going to go into the month and say, okay, this person, I'm going to say, we're going to do the kind of visual opposite. I'm going to say March and Q1. And of course, you can see that I can do it on every single element of the pivot. I can do the product, the region, the month, account, anything I want to limit. It's very simple, nice little user interface, really easy to use. Now, if I come back into those two environments, I think I can just drop this one and the other two should be there. Right. Now, if I ask for the data back this time, you can see how simple that is. Now, I've showed it to you with a really simple little database, but you can see how powerful that could be in a massive enterprise level where I can control how each person is able to access the database, whether they're allowed to write back to the database in that particular element, and whether they're allowed to even visually see that element at all. And that's how you implement row-level security in Excel with a PowerExcel add-in.